Attack center to put her in weapon ready to put it to one. Power up time now.
Weapons free, tube one, aye, sir.
Stand by, tube one.
Ice pick submarine. Bearing 182, 2900 yards.
The USS Hartford, Los Angeles class nuclear attack submarine, readies to fire.
Fire, tube one.
Shoot, tube one.
In an instant, a two-ton, 20-foot-long torpedo speeds towards an enemy submarine.
How long ship's going to get you the target?
Target acquired and destroyed.
All hands stand fast while hovering operations are in progress.
The Hartford is training for its primary mission, hunting and killing enemy ships and submarines.
180 feet, zero angle.
But these exercises, which CNN was given exclusive access to, are taking place in the harshest sea environment in the world.
Cunningham, some units, I'll stop.
Under the Arctic ice.
Chief of the watch on the 1MC. Vertical surface, vertical surface, vertical surface.
Ship has commenced vertical surfacing. As a reminder, all hands, stand fast.
It's an arena where even surfacing requires enormous power and skill.
5 degree up angle, 0.23 upper velocity and increasing.
We were on board as the submarine stalks to the surface with the full force of its 6,000 tons.
Impact!
1,000, 2,000, 3,000, shot!
We've just broken through 2 feet of Arctic ice. The North Pole is this way, Russia is this way, and Alaska this way. And a mission like this is all about sending a message. The U.S. Navy can operate or wage war, if necessary, in the harshest environment in the world.
The Arctic is the newest and most daunting front in the expanding global competition between the U.S. and Russia. These 5.5 million square miles are under an intense battle for dominance as the ice shrinks and opens new oil exploration, new shipping lanes, and crucially, new paths to wage war.
We are well aware that we are in a great power competition environment, and the Arctic is one piece of that.
Great power competition, talking principally about Russia, but also China.
Russia and China are two of our great powers that are, you know, trying to catch up with us as fast as they can.
Operating under the Arctic presents unique challenges with no access to GPS navigation, limited communications, and dangers from below and above.
Ice keel depth times 0.755 feet.
Ice keels as long as 150 feet extend down from the ice sheet.
Stationary dive the ship to 180 feet.
Subs like the Hartford are virtually invisible and silent to enemies, allowing them to strike without warning against targets below and above the surface.
These are two of the four torpedo tubes, but you can launch a lot more from a sub than torpedoes. You have 12 vertical launch tubes. They can launch cruise missiles. From those torpedo tubes, you can also launch unmanned underwater vehicles, drones, becoming more of a focus in this Navy, and some submarines like this equipped to send out SEAL team delivery vehicles as well. These subs designed to project power in many, many ways.
However, Russian and increasingly Chinese submarines are getting better at doing the same.
Shenlock, Bridge to Rye.
Is the Navy becoming more reliant on subs as a platform?
We do expect that submarines are going to be able to get to places and to conduct action where other units may not be able to right off the bat. We're going to need the submarine force to kick the door in and other forces to flow behind.
That is the firm message to audiences in Moscow and beyond.